Assalamu alaikum and welcome to Al Siraat College Community News. Today is Friday, 24th of September. I'm Aisha Esfandia, reporting from the Al Siraat College Newsroom in Epping, Victoria. Childhood cancer awareness was raised throughout September with community advocate Tanya Kubica and daughter Mariam participating in the annual Great Cycle Challenge. Ms. Kubica's family have been supporting this important cause for the past 8 years. We interviewed Ms. Kubica earlier today.
Assalamu alaikum and welcome everyone. Today we'll be having an interview with Ms. Tanya from Al Siraat College regarding the Great Cycle Challenge. Welcome Ms. Tanya, how are you today?
Thank you so much, I'm very good, alhamdulillah.
Fantastic, Ms. Tanya, would you be able to tell us what is the program that you have started?
It's called the Great Cycle Challenge. It's the annual fundraiser for the Children's Medical Research Institute in Sydney, in Westmead. It's been running since 2013, and I've been participating since 2013 as well. So it's my 8th year of fundraising for kids fighting cancer.
MashaAllah, that's an amazing achievement. How much has the challenge raised in regards to funds so far?
So overall, they have raised, it's still going, I think it's about $17 million for cancer research. And my own involvement has been over $34,000 so far in 8 years.
Oh, mashallah, amazing. And when did you get involved and join the Great Cycle Challenge?
I initially started because I saw something on social media about this challenge, and I know I love bike riding anyway, and I wanted to do something good for the community. I've got family with cancer, my grandparents passed away, my uncle, my cousin, a childhood friend's mother, so I think everyone, I know so many people that have been touched and affected by cancer, and especially childhood cancer. It's heartbreaking when you have a child that's in hospital.
Would you be able to tell us how this involvement has changed Miriam's inspiration online?
Alhamdulillah, she is much more positive, and she knows a lot more about how cancer affects children and their family. So it's not just the child, it affects everyone in the family. And also, she learned that it doesn't matter how young or small you are, or a boy or a girl, or if you've scarfed or not, you, as little as you are, you can always have a big impact on other people's lives.
Fantastic. And just before we go, would you be able to tell us about the upcoming events and the dates of when they are about to commence?
Sure, my pleasure. So on 1st of October, the challenge officially kicks off, and it runs throughout the month of October. So it finishes on the 31st of October in regards to the riding. Fundraising will be still available until late November when the organizers publish the official fundraising figure. So I'll be busy throughout next month on my bike with my daughter as often as possible, come sunshine or hail. And I would love to see more students and staff and parents join our team. It's free. You can set your own challenge, how much you want to race and how many or how few kilometers you want to ride and race. So it could be as little as, I don't know, 10 kilometers or 1,000 kilometers, whatever you like.
Fantastic. Well, thank you for your time and with us today, Ms. Tanya. So there you have it, everyone. You've heard it yourself. Please get involved. Great cause. See you then. Assalamu alaikum and thank you again.
The Peaceful Healthy Parenting Program with Catherine Jones attracted recorded numbers throughout September with virtual workshops run weekly via Zoom. Parents were able to navigate topics like understanding inner calm and strength, how to build loving connection in your family, how to set limits peacefully, a step-by-step guide transforming chaos in your family during lockdown, and more. The Peaceful Healthy Parenting Workshops have been proudly supported and funded by City of Whittlesea as part of the Healthy Lifestyle Project. In other news today, Al Siraat College and Land Lease have partnered up for a second year in a row to raise awareness for Are You OK Day. Al Siraat College hosted a range of events for Are You OK Day on 10th September in ways that were COVID safe. A presentation was made by Miss Jules during the Friday night weekly online parents program. Years 3 to 6 students ran Are You OK Day awareness sessions to give students some basic skills and resources to start meaningful conversations with people who they may be worried about. Our on-site operations staff shared in a conversation cafe with cupcakes. This was a much smaller conversation cafe than what we were able to host last year, with 500 cupcakes supplied by Lendlease for students and staff. Al Siraat College are hosting a series of webinars and workshops this year as part of the Interfaith Youth Forum Visual Media Project. This project is proudly supported and funded by the Victorian Government and run in partnership with Whittlesea Interfaith Network, City of Whittlesea, Victoria Police, St. Monica's College, Cinespace and Our Race. Two of the main webinars include Transformational Ethical Storytelling Facilitated by Our Race, as well as the highly popular Social Media for Social Change webinar facilitated by Cinespace Inc. Islamic story time at the Musalla has been a community favourite over the last few years. Sadly, with COVID-19, as with all other community programs, these were cancelled. Instead, these have been replaced with highly popular bedtime story program every Thursday night, suitable for mums and young children. Sessions are run by storyteller Miss Setup and includes nasheeds, stories and nursery rhymes in each session. For the final bedtime story program of Term 3, children welcomed special guest storyteller Miss Najma to share an engaging story and song about feelings. Lastly, a presentation on mental health through COVID-19 was made by crowd favourite Manal Sehab during the final session of Ladies Friday Night Catch-Up of the term. Parents and Friends Forum members are eager to continue the weekly ladies program in Term 4 due to popular demand. More details on all of these projects and more can be found under the newsletter tab in the Al Siraat College website. That wraps up our news report for this week. Thank you for joining us here at Al Siraat College's newsroom. I am Aisha Esfandiar. Assalamu alaikum. Love.